Good evening and welcome all of you in this online lecture. So this lecture is based from the topic alkaloids isolated from the roots of Piperniculum. Okay, already we have finished part 1. This is part 2. This part 2 will cover a 2D NMR, okay, revision of 2D NMR. 2D NMR is essential for to study further in this paper because it already I told in previous lecture that this research paper divided into 3 parts, okay. Isolation of collection of plant material, then extraction isolation, and then structure elucidation, okay. So for structure elucidation part, all these 2D NMR technique, mass, etc. required, okay. So to understand that better, you should know 2D NMR well, okay. That's why we are taking this lecture. So let's start. So 2D NMR revision to understand structure elucidation better. Okay, you can see here one molecule. That molecule I already taken from this research paper only, and research paper already sent on your WhatsApp group. You can download, you can take print of that, and while watching this video you should read that paper also, okay, so you will understand better. So here you can clearly see H1H1 cosy dark line and with arrow HMBC, okay. So already in offline lecture you know this, but revision is more better for this part to understand structure elucidation. So let's see in detail 2D NMR experiment, okay. 2D NMR experiment are two types: homonuclear correlation spectroscopy and heteronuclear correlation spectroscopy. Homonuclear correlation spectroscopy means both nucleus same, COSY, H1H1 correlation, TOGSY, H1H1 correlation, NOSY, ROSY also H1H1 correlation, okay. Heteronuclear correlation spectroscopy, HETCOR, HSQC, HMQC, HMBC, okay. HETCOR, HSQC, HMQC all will show one bond correlation, that is CH correlation. Hydrogen, those attached directly to carbon with one bond, they will show correlation, is cross peaks, okay. Means hydrogen attached to any carbon, that carbon and that hydrogen will show cross peak one bond correlation, directly attached protons with carbon. All HETCOR, HSQC, HMQC will show this only. Difference is there. What difference we will see? HMBC will show 2 bond, 3 bond correlation, carbon and proton only. But 2 bond, 3 bond correlation, sometimes 4 bond also, depending on how much delay they have given, delay time. Okay. So heteronuclear correlation, every time it is not like that H1C13 only. Instead of C13, other hetero atom could be also used, N15 or P31, but depending on experiments, whatever requirement, okay. For our this structure elucidation, natural product H1C13 needed, that's they recorded like this. So first COSY, H1H1 correlation spectroscopy. H1H1 correlation spectroscopy, COSY, shows the correlation between hydrogen which are coupled to each other in the H1 NMR spectrum. The H1 spectrum is plotted on both 2D axis. While 2 bond and 3 bond H1H1 coupling is easily visible by COSY, long range coupling can also be observed with long acquisition times. Okay, this line is very important. While 2 bond and 3 bond H1H1 coupling is easily visible by COSY, long range coupling can also be observed with long acquisition time. Okay, see here this part, that largest chain, largest branch of this molecule. Okay, COSY should not show, miss COSY actually not showing this much, but with more acquisition time. See this part, Ideally, Toxie is using for this long range coupling, okay, but sometimes, as we said, there more acquisition time can show long range coupling in COSY also. That's why this molecule showing this much carbon hydrogen under COSY. Otherwise, COSY is just for up to four bond only, like this, okay. But sometimes with more acquisition type, it can show like this also. While two bond and three bond H1 coupling is easily visible by COSY, long range coupling can also observed with long acquisition times. Okay, the cross peaks, those not on the diagonal that are symmetric to the diagonal, show COSY correlations. Toxy total correlation spectroscopy. This is also H1 correlation. Toxy total correlation spectroscopy shows correlation between all protons within a given spin system, not just between geminal or vicinal protons as in COSY. Okay, what is spin system and how it stop transfer of magnetism? We'll see. Correlation are seen between distant proton as long as there are coupling between every intervening protons. This is extremely useful for identifying protons on sugar rings or amino acid or peptides. All protons on given sugar ring will have correlation with all other protons on the same ring, but not with protons on different rings. See, this is Toxy and COSY spectrum of this molecule. So you can see four in COSY spectrum, as we said, four is coupling with five, five is coupling with six, six is coupling with seven. But in COSY, you will not see four coupling with seven. With long acquisition time, it is possible, but primarily four will not couple with seven, four will not couple with six. Okay, so here you can see also in COSY. Four coupling with five. Four is coupling with five. Then five should couple with six. See, five coupling with six. Six should couple with seven. Coupling with seven, but there will no peak of four and seven. See, seven and four, no peak. There will no peak seven and five also. See, seven and five absent. But in Toxy, four and seven will be there. See, four and seven, and then four and six also there. See, here four, five also there. Four, six, and four, five also there. So this is difference between COSY and Toxy. Okay, we said what is spin system. So see, this molecule divided into two parts by carbonyl. Okay, so on carbonyls, one side there will be one spin system and other side there will be other spin system. So 4, 5, 6, 7 will come together in COSY, and 1 and 2 will come together as a set in, sorry, 4, 5, 6, 7 will come in Toxy, and 1 and 2 also come in Toxy. Okay, but in COSY only 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, like that correlation will be seen. Okay. This is spin system. Why we are telling this is one spin system, this is one system? Because magnetizing transfer will not transfer as here, proton is absent here. Okay, so it will cover this part only in one system and this part in one system. So this set and this set together will be seen in Toggzy. Okay, I correct this. I told something like cozy instead of Toggzy, so correct that. This system and this system will be seen in Toggzy. Okay, and in cozy like this all together will not be seen, only 4 5 5 6 6 7 like that will be seen. Okay, no any 4 to 7 4 to 6 like that will not seen in cozy. That is basic difference in cozy and Toggzy. Toggzy, this is Toggzy spectra only, same molecule. You can pause and watch it. Okay, NOSY nuclear Overhauser effect spectroscopy or EGSY. Okay, H1 NOSY nuclear Overhauser effect spectroscopy and EGSY are the same experiment used for different purpose. NOSY is useful for determining which signal arise from proton that are close to each other in space, even if they are not bonded. Close means within 6 angstrom, 5 angstrom. Okay, a NOSY spectrum yields through space correlation via spin-spin lattice relaxation. There spin is missing. Okay, via spin-spin lattice relaxation. NOSY also detects chemical and conformational exchange. It is called EGSY when used for this purpose. Okay, so NOSY EGSY same only, but if used for this purpose, conformational exchange and all this, then it will be EGSY. ROSY, rotating frame Overhauser effect spectroscopy, same as NOE. Okay, same, nothing is outcome wise, it will be same only result wise. Both acting through space only. H1 ROSY rotating frame Overhauser effect spectroscopy is useful for determining which signal arises from proton that are close to each other within 6 angstrom in space, even if they are not bonded. ROSY spectrum yields through space correlation via spin-spin relaxation. ROSY also detect chemical and conformational exchange. Okay, so difference not in result, difference in while this NMR spectra being recorded that time only. Okay, that is also because for large molecule NO is preferable, for mid-size molecule RO is preferable, and that is actually depending on one equation only, the formula. That formula I don't have included here, but it is something rotational correlation time. Okay, that matters. That's why according to size of molecule it is decided whether ROE or NOE should be conducted. Okay, so molecule whose rotational correlation time falls in a range where the NOE is too weak to be detectable, there RO is essential. Okay, so there then they what they are doing, instead of observing cross relaxation from an initial state of Z magnetization, the equilibrium magnetization is rotated onto the X axis and then spin locked by an external magnetic field. Okay, so that it cannot precess. Then it is like spin lock NOE, and spin lock NOE is nothing but ROE. Okay, that is for molecule size only. Okay, according to that equation, one equation is there in next lecture. If you want, I will show also. According to that, depending on molecular size and rotational rotational correlation time, it is decided whether ROE or NOE. Okay, otherwise result wise it is same only. Only size matters, that's why. Generally for large molecule NOE and mid size molecule ROE. Okay, according to that equation it is decided. For now just remember application. Okay, because application we are going to see of this technique. That is anyway beyond this lecture. Okay, so it is enough for this. If you want, I will share that formula later. ROE, okay. ROE. See, one example we will see here. Due to different conformation or folding, proton that are not bonded can come in close proximity within 6 angstrom or 5 angstrom and can show a new ROE signal. Okay, for example, here H15 showing ROE with H23. Okay, H15. Here 1H and here 1H. Okay, they are showing ROE. Okay, means this molecule may be folded like that. This two protons coming near. Okay, that's why H15 and H23 showing ROE or here ROE. Okay, next head core. So from here, heteronuclear correlation spectroscopy. Heteronuclear correlation spectroscopy. It is a two-dimensional NMR technique which reveals spin-spin coupling between H1 and C13. The head core spectrum correlated C13 with directly attached proton. So it is H1 C13 coupling, one bond coupling. Sorry, one bond correlation. The cross peak means correlation between proton and carbon. If light does not have cross peak, this means that this carbon atom has no attached proton, quaternary carbon atom. HMQC gives same result, but it's more efficient. Okay, because HMQC is hydrogen proton detected technique and head core is carbon detected, so that is less efficient, and that's why head core is not that much used now. But for any purpose where more C13 resolution, or when fine resolution in the C13 dimension required to differentiate similar C13 shift, that time head core is preferable. Okay, then HSPC, heteronuclear single quantum correlation or coherence spectroscopy. Okay, H1 C13 heteronuclear single quantum coherence spectroscopy HSPC shows which hydrogen are directly attached which carbon atom. The H1 spectrum is shown on the horizontal axis and C13 spectrum is shown on the vertical axis. The HSQC spectrum is most valuable when protons have already been assigned. HMQC heteronuclear multiple quantum correlation or coherence spectroscopy. HMQC will give same information as head core gives, only more efficient. That is why only directly bonded hydrogen and carbon will give cross peaks. Quaternary carbon will not show any cross peak, has no hydrogen attached directly. See, this is head core spectrum. Here you can see, suppose consider this F carbon, then F carbon and F carbon and F hydrogen should show peaks here. F carbon, F hydrogen, okay. Then B carbon, B hydrogen, B carbon, B hydrogen. See here, like this. Okay, direct correlation, one bond CH. This is sample spectra, HMQC, HMBC. HMBC, heteronuclear multiple bond coherence spectroscopy. HMBC is a 2D experiment used to correlate or connect H1 and C13 peak for atoms separated by multiple bonds, 2 or 3. The coordinate of each peak seen in the counter plot are H1 and C13 chemical shift. This is extremely useful for making assignments and mapping out covalent structure. The information obtained is an extension of that obtained from HMQC spectrum, but is more complicated to analyze, of course, but useful also. HMBC, okay, HMBC is useful for structure elucidation. See here, HMBC see वन हाइड्रोजन हेयर हो गए, सो एच एम बी सी इस जी थ्री और टू बॉन्ड कोरिलेशन ना, सो दिस इज वन बॉन्ड, सेकंड बॉन्ड, थर्ड बॉन्ड, ओके, सो 19 कार्बन एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन शुड शो एच एम बी सी, दैट्स वाई ब्लू एरो शोन हेयर, ओके, वन टू थ्री 17 एंड दिस 15 हाइड्रोजन ऑल्सो शोन कोरिलेशन, ओके, दिस इज एच एम बी सी. रिमेंबर दैट एच वन सी 13, एच एम बी सी इज एच वन सी 13 कोरिलेशन, ओके, एंड इफ इवन हेयर एरो 19 टू 15 कार्बन कार्बन, समबडी एनी वन कैन फील दैट 19 एंड 15 कार्बन, इट इज़ नॉट कार्बन हाइड्रोजन, ओके, बिकॉज एच एम बी सी इज एच वन सी 13 कोरिलेशन, सो 15 हाइड्रोजन एंड 19 कार्बन, 15 हाइड्रोजन 17 कार्बन, लाइक दैट, ओके, बिकॉज ऑन 19 एंड 17 देर इज नो हाइड्रोजन ऑल्सो. You will understand, okay, this is three bond to bond correlation, just remember H1C13, HMBC. Summary, homonuclear correlation spectroscopy, COSY, TOGSY, NOSY, ROSY, all are H1-H1 correlation, okay, COSY, anyway now you know, they will show two neighboring proton, but also beyond that with weak intensity or with weak intensity and more acquisition time, okay, they can show some long range coupling also, but basically neighboring proton only, J3 like means three bond correlation, okay. TOGSY, total spin system unless heteroatom or other disruption, unless and until magnetization not stopped by any heteroatom or carbonyl group like thing, it will not stop and it will cover all total spin system in TOGSY. No zero z through space, okay, remember that. Heteronuclear correlation spectroscopy, het core HSQC, HMQC, HMBC, het core HSQC, HMQC, all will show one bond correlation, okay. One bond correlation directly attached carbon and hydrogen, all het core HSQC, HMQC, only HMBC will show H1C13, that is two or three bond, sometimes four bond also, okay. Four bond when there is some means if we change delay time, okay, depending on delay we can, one can optimize also J3, J4, J2 like that, okay, for J3 70 microsecond something delay time, like that one can optimize, or depending on delay time it can vary, but mostly in J2, J3, 2 bond, 3 bond correlation seen in HMBC are people using like that. This data taken from your research paper only. So here you can see COSY in this long range because large acquisition time. Here as usual up to 4 bonds COSY showing anyway. Here 1, 2, 3 bond only, okay, neighboring proton anyway, COSY showing primarily neighboring proton only, these things up to 4 bond it goes sometime, okay, and this large core means long range coupling, it is because more acquisition time, okay, so this we are going to see in detail in next lecture anyway. So first in this lecture just remember all these techniques, that's it. Here we will take example, this is very first molecule from research paper, those we discussed na in part 1, 7 amides, 7 amide alkaloids isolated, in that 7 this is first molecule, okay, N isobutyl 4 hexanoyl 4 hydroxy pyrrolidine. So in those 7 amide alkaloids, this is first molecule, N isobutyl 4 hexanoyl 4 hydroxy pyrrolidine 1 1, okay. So anyway, According to molecular formula, we can understand how many sites of unsaturation there. According to you, we can understood two sites goes for this carbonyl and all those. So once one site of unsaturation remaining, that we can decide if any alkene or cycle. So confirmation of cycle also needed, okay, and that confirmation of cycle is done and supported by HMBC data, okay. So here HB1, HB1 same, no, it should not be same because the chiral center is present and these protons are diastereotopic, okay. So there it should be HA1 dash. By mistake they both become HB1 dash, but it is HA1 dash, okay. So because of chiral center, these protons are diastereotopic and they are HB1 dash, HA1 dash, okay. So HB1 dash, in paper it is given HB1 dash showing HMBC with C4C1, but HA1 dash will also show, okay. So for now, whatever given in paper, HB1 dash will show HMBC with C4 and C1, okay. C3. Three bond, okay, purple color, okay, three bond. HB1 will show with C4 and C1, okay. HA3, HB3 will show with C1, C5, three bond, okay, you can count. HA2, HB2 will show C4 with HMBC with C4 and C1. Here only two bond, but anyway two bond correlation also except means seen in HMBC NOE, okay. And now let's see NOE C4 and H3B, H1 dash, H2 dash, H3 dash, means this part and this part will show you again. H3B also will show NOE, okay. So NOE is H1 H1 correlation. It will not miss, it should not be C4. It is like hydroxy group of C4, hydroxy groups hydrogen, okay. Hydroxy group present on C4 and its proton will show NOE correlation with this H3B, H1 dash, H2 dash, H3 dash, means this site is confirmed with NOE also, HMBC also. So this like this thing supporting whatever the rough structure obtained. Anyway, these people doing research on alkaloids already. Some alkaloids from these roots, fruits and plant reported. So they at least had one rough idea how would be the structure. With H1 DPT also have some more rough idea. So only thing remaining was to confirm. So confirmation done by HMBC NOE, okay. And COSY also of course support. So COSY, here what COSY, H1 H1 COSY correlation define three spin system, one involving proton of isobutyl amino group. This, okay, one involving proton of N amyl group from H6 to H10, and one involving proton due to coupled methylene HA2, HB2, HA3, HB3. This, see, because of COSY, NOE, HMBC, this structure confirmed like this data, and this structure belong to like this structure, okay. Means because of this data, this research group people confirm structure of this first compound is this only, okay. Thanks for watching. The rest of the things we will see in next lecture. For now this is enough. Thanks for watching.